This is a story about a security issue that I found a year ago that allowed me to take over any Outlook account. And because of this finding, I was later invited to Black Hat USA to speak with the Microsoft security team about this finding. This was an extremely lucky finding for me, and I was later rewarded $20,000 for this report. This video is not just for bug bounty hunters who are trying to find their next bug, but also for all the developers who are interested in knowing how to secure their web applications to avoid similar flaws. This story starts with a tweet from MSRC. I saw that and thought, great, time to have some fun. I quickly opened my laptop and Burp and took a few hours just clicking around Microsoft's products. I wasn't able to find anything interesting at first, but then some highlighted requests caught my eyes. I later found that they are highlighted because of the plugin I used, JSON Web Token Attackers. And the plugin would highlight anything that either has a JWT in the request or in the response. So I casually navigated to the plugins tab and clicked around. The auth header looks fine. The payload looks fine as well. And the signature looks empty. A JWT without a signature is the worst JWT for web applications. For those who don't know, JWT has three parts: header, payload, and signature. Header and payload contain the user's information in order to communicate with the server. The signature part is to make sure the header and the payload are generated by the server / Microsoft in this case, instead of generated by someone else on the internet. So you can imagine why a JWT without a signature is the best JWT for a hacker, because now the hacker can become anyone by changing the header and the payload. The plan I had was like this. First, I need to figure out what this JWT can access, then try to change the JWT parameters to another user's ID and apply this JWT to as many endpoints as possible to access the full impact. To do this, I had to go to the documentation and learn how to find relevant information. The first easy API call I could find was to read my personal email messages. After successfully reading my personal email with a JWT that has an empty signature, I changed the OID in the JWT to my other test user's OID. And surprisingly, I can also see my test user's email messages after swapping the OID value in the JWT. So this was clearly a valid security issue because I can basically read any other Outlook user's email messages without user interaction. I submitted this finding to Microsoft and later found that this is actually a duplicate report. My friend Terry reported the same finding earlier than me, but Microsoft decided my report has helped them to act on the issue quickly, so they wanted to also give me a reward to thank me for the effort. This bug was unusual, and I really appreciate the way Microsoft handled my report. The takeaway here is, remember to check all the tabs in the Burp plugin JWT Attacker. Thank you all and see you in the next video.